I am Sajjan Dixit, working as a technical project manager in this project. Now we have a demo on AVU. So before going to practical demo, I want to discuss some things, how server works and what are the requirements. So you will get the familiar with this technology. So we will start requirements. What are the requirements for AVU? You all are familiar with AVU. AVU is a online teaching tool. A teacher can be used for teaching or to show video to the remote centers. Everything is there. Teacher can write on the whiteboard, teacher can upload the slides in that, and teacher can share the desktop screen also in AVU. So what are the requirements for AVU? So first and very important is internet bandwidth. 1 Mbps stable and dedicated bandwidth you will need in your classroom. And that line should not be connected through proxy server. Under the proxy, this software does not work. So you will have to bypass that line from your proxy server if you are using proxy server in your institute. If you have multiple gateways in the institute, you will need static public IP address on the system which will be used for AVU transmission. If you have single gateway in the institute, there is no need to assign public IP address on the system. So if you have multiple gateway, you have to be assigned static public IP address in the system on AVU machine. Second, you will need PC, well configured personal computer. It should have Windows XP and Windows 7, but we recommend you that you use Windows XP, because in the Windows 7 machine there are lots of security issues. You have to enable that security in the Windows system, and you are not familiar with doing this. So we recommend you should use Windows XP machine.
Sir, we are talking about open source.
Yeah.
So why we are using Windows XP or Windows 7?
The
why we are not
is
using
that development of AVU is not controlled by IIT Bombay.
Okay.
Amrita is developing that. They are planning to do this technology in AVU in open source, but it will take some time. So right now we have no choice.
Thank you.
I have 2 points here. Recently, for technical staff, we conducted on Windows 7. So I had some personal question. Second, on Ubuntu, I have tried this AVU. It was working through Wine software, Windows emulator. It was working fine.
If it is working fine, you can use. But we recommended you. Suddenly, you face the problem during the interaction time. Suppose the important event on 10th and 11th. Suddenly, you find that some problems in the machine. There is no solution on that time. So that's why you use. If you tested earlier that, it's not a problem. But if you use first time, then we recommend you use Windows XP machine.
So this is regarding the video transmission as well as audio transmissions.
Yes, yes.
So whenever we are pressing the refresh button on that particular AVU software, we are getting that good quality transmission under.
Okay.
After a few seconds, 10 to 10, even though we are running with 10 Mbps internet bandwidth connectivity, we are getting that particular poor quality audio sometime.
Yeah, problem is that if you are using perfect sound system, there is no problem in the audio and video. Because if some problem in IIT Bombay, all the connected centers will get same problem. If only some centers getting some problem, that means problem at your side. Maybe you have updated Adobe Air. There is a bug in Adobe Air 3.4. So if you accidentally updated Adobe Air, then you will get that problem. Audio breaking things, and sometimes video frozen. And maybe your system is not well configured.
So, okay.
Try to understand, if problem in IIT Bombay, all the connected center will get same problem. Let us continue this. So PC, with minimum 2 GB RAM you require. Third, you will need professional microphone. Before come to the audio, we need a video camera first. With a tripod. So you will need handycam or professional professional camera. Please do not use webcam. Webcam is only for single user. You cannot zoom on that particular person who is sitting behind during the interaction time. Suppose suddenly your center is selected by president on that time, you cannot zoom on that particular face. So please use handycam or professional camera. So how can you connect this camera to PC? You will need some device to connect camera to PC. So it could be USB. Some modern camera support USB for live transmission, but most of the old camera does not support this. When you connect your camera through USB, your camera is detected in system, then you can configure in AView that camera. But if you connect your old camera through USB, it shows that mass storage. That means you can transfer the file from the camera, recorded file, but you cannot see the live video interface in the system. So that means your camera does not support for that. So if your camera does not support USB, you will need FireWire card or video capture device. Video capture device, there are two types of video capture device is available in the market. One could be PCI or USB. So whatever you are getting in the market, in your local market, you purchase that. If it is PCI, you can purchase PCI. If it is USB, you can purchase that. If your camera supports USB, then there is no need to purchase video capture device and FireWire card. If your camera has FireWire out, then you should go with IEEE 1394 card, FireWire card. If your camera does not have that FireWire output, then you will need video capture device to connect your camera in the system. Now you will need one professional microphone. Please do not use headphone microphone and podium microphone. If you have a wireless microphone, that would be better or ideal. You will need audio system. So earlier some of the centers used single amplifier. That is not a good connection, because when you connect your microphone directly in the system, your local audio will not listen in your side. So if you connect two amplifiers in your classroom, that would be the better or ideal system, ideal connection. If you do not have two amplifiers, you should use one audio mixer. So you can connect, you can take output from the audio mixer and connect to the amplifier, and second you can connect to the system, alternate output of the audio mixer. So one because suppose you connect a microphone and the teacher's audio in the single amplifier, echo will generate, because you are taking output from that same amplifier and you connected in the system. That audio also goes to IIT Bombay, because teacher So audio is also going to that amplifier and you are taking output. So it is looping. So that's why you have to skip that. If you have a single amplifier, you should connect direct your microphone in the system, otherwise use audio amplifier or another alternate amplifier. So you can use one amplifier for your own local audio and one amplifier for teacher audio. Please do not connect your microphone in the single amplifier if you are using. Now you will need AV package. So some of the remote centers are in the confusion that we are using 3.0. IIT Bombay server accept only 1.5 AV. So you have to use 1.5 version of AV Classroom. Please do not use 3.0. Amrita e-learning used 3.0. They have a central server, so all the requests go there. IIT Bombay has own server, so you have to use AV version 1.5 every time. So it is available on our website. You can download, or we have already provided to you. There is no need to download 3.0. So every time use 1.5 AV version. So inside AV package, there are four softwares. So first is AV Classroom, second Adobe Air. Adobe is a runtime to run the desktop application. So you will need Adobe Air version 2.5. Along with AV, we are providing you Adobe Air version 2.5. When you install right now, version 3.4 is also available. But when you update 3.5 version, you will get some problem at your side, audio breaking, login failure problem. So please do not update the Adobe Air. Install 2.5 version. Whenever it asks for updation, please do not update Adobe Air. Every time you should use 2.5 version. If suddenly, accidentally you updated that, the solution is uninstall AV, uninstall Adobe Air, and reinstall AV again. In AV package, Adobe Air is already there. Third is Java runtime. To share the desktop, Java runtime is required. So you will need Java also in the system. And screen camera. Screen camera is needed to connect your camera in the PC and send encoding video in the AV. So screen camera is also needed. So there are four packages inside AV.
Actually, I would like to know the exact purpose of the screen camera, sir. Screen camera.
Yeah, without a screen camera, you cannot connect your camera in AV. You cannot configure that camera in AV because the stream comes through a screen camera in AV.
No, actually, when we installed AV, screen camera got installed, yes. But I'm using a video capture device.
No, that automatically captured from that. When you start the AV, but best way to, please do not skip that. You should start first screen camera, after that you should start your AV.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, so now we continue. Yeah, server and how it works. So in IIT Bombay we have three servers. So under the main server, there are three servers. One is database server. In the database server, we are using MySQL and LCDS for desktop connecting. You are using desktop application for AV to connect that desktop application in MySQL. For connection purpose, we are using LCDS, Live Cycle Data Services. D this LCDS works on port number 8700. So make sure your port number 8700 must be opened in router as well as your firewall. Second is video server. Video server, we are using FMS, Flash Media Streaming Server. It works on port 1935. So that's port should must be opened also in firewall as well as router. Third is content server. For whiteboard and document, we are using content server, and that this server works on port 80. Connected to direct internet line. So when you install the AVO, first when you try to log in, port 8700 will be used. Then if connection established, then you will get the another interface of the list of virtual classroom. Every time you should use the appropriate classroom which you have been assigned. If you will see two classes there, that means you have been assigned two classes, but you have to enter in the classroom which you want to enter on that classroom. So in this workshop you have to use Aakash for education class every time, not new remote center testing. Last time we found that some of the centers enter in that wrong classroom, new remote center testing. When you, your login is successful, suppose your login is successful, then video is not coming. That means problem in port number 1935. Under the status bar of AVU, you can see video is connecting, audio, whiteboard is connecting. That means port number 1935 is blocked in your router or in your firewall. So you should be, you have to open this port. 80 always open in all the servers. So now let us see the connection diagram of audio video equipments. Suppose this is your system, it is connected to the internet. You have camera, handycam. So to connect your camera, you will need, there are three options. USB, FireWire, video capture device. If your camera supports USB for live transmission, you can connect through USB cable. If your camera has FireWire out, you can connect through FireWire, but you will need FireWire card in the system also. If you do not have both of the device, you will need video capture device. So connect your camera through video capture device. So using video capture device, you can connect your camera. There are four inputs in the video capture device. You will have to use only yellow color composite input in the capture device. Please do not connect audio cables red and white in that easy cap device. You will have to use only yellow color cable.
Sir, our technician has said that if we connect a camera in USB slot, then its quality is low.
No. If your camera supports through USB, you can use, no problem.
Our camera has both port, fire port bhi hai sir, usme wo dono hi hai.
You can use either USB or a video capture device or FireWire, your choice.
Thanks, sir.
So now, mic to connect microphone to the system. Best and ideal connection diagram is that you use every time audio mixer and single amplifier. So suppose this is your amplifier, these two are the speakers connected to this amplifier. Take output from the PC audio output and connect direct to the amplifier. Please do not connect that cable in the audio mixer. If you are using wireless microphone, your wireless receiver's output must be connected to audio mixer. If you are using wired mic, connect same way, connect through same way. Take one output from, there are multiple outputs you will get in the audio mixer. So one output should be connected to the amplifier and take alternate output for PC and connect in the PC. PC's line in option. There are two inputs in the system to connect audio. One is mic in, second is line in. If you are getting pre-amplified signal in from a microphone, you should connect in the line in. There is no need to amplify again. If you are using low gain audio, you should connect in mic in. Suppose you are using, you do not have audio mixer and you want to connect your wired microphone in the system, every time you use mic in, because there is no pre-amplified facility in the wired microphone. If you are using wireless microphone, the signal is already pre-amplified. So this is the difference in line in and mic in. You have PC. To connect your camera, you will need video capture device, FireWire card or USB. You have wireless microphone or wired microphone. Best or ideal way to connect your audio, you every time you use audio mixer along with single amplifier. So through audio mixer you can connect your receiver, and there are multiple outputs in the audio mixer. Take one output for PC, take one output for amplifier, and your system's audio output must be connected direct to the amplifier. Please do not connect that cable in the audio mixer, otherwise echo will regenerate again. And using VGA splitter, you can connect monitor as well as projector using single output of the VGA output, monitor output. So suppose this is a VGA splitter. Connect PC's VGA output to the VGA splitter and take two output, one for projector, one for monitor. Okay, now we have actual demo. Before going to the actual demo, some checklist is there. So what are the checklists to start a view? Best way to start a view. So first you check in the Internet Explorer that proxy authentication is assigned or not in the Internet Explorer. If you are using Google Chrome, Mozilla, please do not open Mozilla and Google Chrome, because Windows machine take the proxy setting or system proxy setting from the Internet Explorer. So every time open Internet Explorer. So this is the IP of our server. Type that IP in the Internet Explorer. So we are not typing this IP because we are using local machine, local server for AVU. Yeah, you have to write that IP in the address bar of Internet Explorer. 10.129.178.122. Please do not write this 10. This is our local IP address. So it works. That means Apache is working properly in our server. Go to options, tools, internet options, connections, LAN settings. Your internet is connected you bypass the line from proxy server. So every time you should check this. This should be unchecked. Right now it is checked, but at your side, these both of these should be unchecked. So in the address bar, after the 59.162.23.82, you have to write :8700 to check the port 8700 is opened or blocked. So it will take some time. You will get their LCDS services. Yeah, now you can see welcome to the Adobe Lifecycle Data Service. If you will not get this type of interface, that means port 8700 is blocked in your firewall or router. So if that port is blocked, you will get the problem in login. So these are the some checklists before you start the AVU. You should open your Internet Explorer and check proxy is there or not. Type IP address 59.162.23.82 and press the enter. You will see there it works. That means Apache server and your internet connection is working properly. Then type :8700. So when you press the enter again, you will get this interface. If you will not get this interface, that means port 8700 is blocked. Contact your network coordinator to open that. When you will get this interface properly, after that you should start screen camera first. When you installed AVU screen camera, you can find on the desktop. So start screen camera. This is the configuration to configure your camera in screen camera. So click on that. Select webcam tab, second one. When you insert your camera in the system through your device, FireWire, USB or video capture device, you will get the list of devices here. So select your device. Press the connect button. So your video will be visible here. If you are not getting video there, that means problem in the wire or in the camera or in the driver or in the device. Right now it is in black and white mode. So when you press the settings, there are some adjustments are there. You can change the color, brightness, contrast. So these are the options. So according to your choice, you can choose these. Now press OK button. Press this icon top middle, there is a icon. Press this button to see the video interface of your camera. So click on that. Yeah, now you can see your video is here. That is not in the entire screen of screen camera. So whatever you will see in this interface, that same video will be visible to IIT Bombay. So now go to full screen. Click on that third icon, press that. So when you press the third icon, video will be in the full window. So now keep this alive. Please do not close this screen camera. Now you should start AVU. Fill up your username and password. Every time we receive the phone, what is our username, what is our password? You understand there are 290 centers. We cannot remember all the username and password. So we have sent mail to you, just open your email account and check.
Sir, whenever we are keeping that open screen camera, every time whenever we enter the password and that ID, it will give the message, close the screen camera whenever we are using the XP. Whenever we are using the Windows 7, at that time we have to minimize it.
No, no, we have not faced this kind of problem. If you faced, please send the screenshot of that. So we have to find out that okay. What is the problem.
Okay. But I have did the communication after closing that also. We no, don't no. have any ID video from your side or my side.
Sometimes it takes default.
Okay.
In the background.
Okay.
You closed.
Okay. As well as one thing you told that in the setting, so many options are there.
Yeah.
But we have to select only PAL. If we are selecting yeah. the NTSC, it will give the again only
yes,
lines.
That means your camera provides to PAL.
In yes. India, we have to use that PAL only.
Yeah, if your camera provides signal PAL, then you should select PAL. If your camera provides to you NTSC, you should select NTSC.
Yeah, yeah.
So now fill up your username, password, and every time select IITB server 2. Now server 2 is available to you. If you have multiple display, multiple screens there, you can go with multiple mode, multiple window mode. Otherwise, you should select only single window mode. It will take some time. Suppose you get here some, please check your username and password. That means entered username as password is wrong. If you get that network problem error, network connection error, that means port number 8700 is blocked. If you face the problem in login or audio breaking, just go to control panel. Add remove programs. And I already said that Adobe Air it is running. So check the version of Adobe Air by clicking this. So you can see 2.5. If you accidentally updated it, and you find out there 3.4, sometimes you will face the problem. Login failure, audio is breaking, video quality is not good, video is not continuous. So every time you should use 2.5. If you accidentally updated, please uninstall Adobe Air as well as AView and reinstall AView. And whenever it asks for updation, please do not update Adobe Air. Close. So if login is successful, you will get this interface. You have to click on the classroom. After that, you will find the list of virtual classrooms. So this is now you have been appointed as this orientation class. You have been assigned orientation class. So double click on that. So this person provide you the list of users. If all the things are working properly and you are not able to find your institute name here, that means port number 1935 is blocked in your firewall or router. So you can see in the status user connected, video connected, whiteboard connected, that means port is opened. If it shows connecting, that means port is blocked and you will not get your institute name here. There are three ports, 8700, 1935 and 80. So this is teacher side interface, remote center side interface. You can see hand raise button here and video top of this interface. So please do not press the hand raise button unnecessarily. We faced lots of problem here in IIT Bombay. Suddenly we have to scroll and somebody press the hand raise, their list reshuffled. So please do not press the hand raise button. If we announce this, you have any questions, after that you should press the hand raise button. By double clicking, suppose on that time valedictory function, inaugural function, slides will be not there. So by clicking on the video, you can see video in full screen. Suppose teacher is selected some center, another a center. So by using student video tab, you can see that center interaction. Video will be here and audio you will get. we face some problems that sometimes you called me that audio is not properly coming from that remote center, because all the centers provide different gain of audio. So we cannot control that, because you are getting audio video stream from the server. We in IIT Bombay have an audio mixer and gainer, so we can increase the gain. But you have to increase the gain from your audio mixer or your amplifier. We cannot do that. So I am requesting to all the centers, please provide better audio and video reception from your side. And some important points. Your camera, we found that in the technical workshop, your camera goes standby mode many times. So if we found, teacher will select another center and you miss that opportunity. Because out of 250 centers, teacher hardly get to time to interact with the centers. So check your manual of camera, and there are two settings. One is demo mode. There are two options. One is on and off. Every time it should be off. And second is automatic shut off. There are three options: 5 minutes, 10 minutes, and never. It should be in never mode. So your camera will not go in the standby mode, and you will not face that Sony 80 GB hard disk, some transitions are there. So every time you should do this, you must do this. And the ideal position, we found lots of centers keep the camera right hand side or left hand side and right hand side. So that is not ideal position. Please keep the camera, if your screen is above, then you can put the camera below the screen or near to the screen, this position or this position. So the entire classroom will be visible on that time. You will focus on that screen on that time, and your side face will be visible to IIT Bombay on that time. That is not good. So every time you should keep the camera near to the screen. If you have a short cable, please arrange long cable. Right now we selected 10 centers to interact. That 10 centers will be selected by President of IIT Bombay on 11th. Before 10th, we will test all the centers. We will send a testing schedule to all the centers. Please be available for testing. Only one time will be given to you, because to handle 250 centers, it is very difficult within 3 days. Some checklist you can do at your side. Your audio is working or not, video is working or not. Now, you click on that setting buttons to start your stream. First, you configure your camera and audio device in the A view. Select your camera. Select your microphone device, Realtek, SoundMax, SigmaTel. Please do not connect your camera's red and white cable in the EasyCap device. You are not taking audio from that camera. You have a separate microphone that is connected to the system, Realtek, SoundMax or SigmaTel. So every time you should select Realtek, SoundMax, SigmaTel, whatever you have in the system, select. It would be better if you use the student side. During the interaction time, well, we say over to you, that means over to you, and you start your query. Please do not ask that, am I audible, am I visible? You can check pre-testing at your side. When you press the start button in A view, right hand side, you can see a pop-up of video. So now this is the interface of remote center side. Video of the teacher will be visible here. When you double click on that, video will be in the full screen mode. If slides and whiteboards are there, there is no need to double click on that. The slides and document will be visible here, whiteboard visible here also. Then suddenly teacher changes that whiteboard, you will get the same interface of whiteboard also. So now press the settings to configure your camera and audio device. Select devices, select video quality. If you have good bandwidth, you can choose 256, otherwise every time you should use 128. This is the upload bandwidth of your side. If you have good bandwidth, downloading bandwidth, but you do not have upload bandwidth, then we face the video problem at your side, your center side. Your video sometimes not continuous, your video is frozen sometimes. So as per your bandwidth, you select the video quality, save the settings, press the start button. When you press the start button, your local video will be visible there. So there is no need to ask that, am I visible, am I, whatever you will see in this box, that same video will be visible to IIT Bombay. Now record your own sound in the system that you are audible or not. So first double click on the volume control. Options, properties. This is the mixer device. This is the output. In the output, master volume, wave, SW synth should be checked. Rest things should be unchecked. So uncheck all. There is no need to provide line in microphone in the output. Otherwise, echo will come. So only three options, master volume, wave, and SW synth should be check there. Close. Okay. Now select options, properties, select input, recording, line in, mic in, options there for recording. So if you have inserted cable in the line in option, you should okay that you should select line in. If you have inserted your microphone cable in the mic in, you should select mic. And this is the volume control to increase the volume of your microphone. So whatever you are using input of the audio device for recording, you should select appropriate option there. If you have inserted cable line in and you have selected mic in, audio will not come. Close this, open Realtek. So another interface, if you have a Realtek device in the system, open that, go to mixer. This interface for playback, this interface for recording. So same option you will get there, line volume, mic volume, stereo mix. So some of the Realtek device, the volume control is disabled. So that means all inputs are carried together. So you should mute stereo mix every time. This is the stereo mix. Every time this should be muted, otherwise echo will generate. I am repeating again, stereo mix of the Realtek device, every time that should be muted. And you will get here in another Realtek option, volume control of the Realtek of microphone. So you will get same circle here, that is the volume control of all input devices. So you have to increase that right hand side. Now right click on the volume icon, select adjust audio property. Adjust. Right click on the volume control, select adjust audio property, select audio tab and find out the devices. Output, you are using your output, same output device which you are using for AVU. Select sound recording. Now you can see USB there. You have connected your microphone in the Realtek. So you should select Realtek there. Apply. Select again. Apply. Okay. Now your camera is configured properly in AVU. Now you should go to the sound recorder for pre-testing. Go to accessories, entertainment, sound recorder.
We have checked it on the sound recorder. We get the signals on the sound recorder. But still, last time when workshop was going on, we tried to contact you 3-4 times. My voice was not reachable to you. Any other changes you can suggest me?
Problem is that you have selected USB or Realtek there, but you have not selected that same device in the AVU.
In the AVU.
AVU.
Settings in the AVU.
Recording as well as in AVU.
Okay. Okay, thank you.